So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back to another session of PIB Current Affairs. In this session, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams of central government or the state governments or any regulatory body. So let's begin the session, and before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon if you are coming here for the first time, and you can also join this Telegram group. Iska link you will find in the description, and here you will get the PDF of this session. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding the Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana? But the question is, why we are discussing about Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana? This is because it is in news. Ye news mein tha, because Banaras Locomotive Works. Banaras Locomotive Works has organized a function for distribution of self-employment toolkits and certificates for successful trainees under the Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana. Okay? So that is why it is in news. Now we have to discuss in brief about Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana also. So remember guys, this scheme, this program, this Yojana was launched in the previous month, September 2021, of course by the Ministry of Railways, because as the name suggests, it is Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana. And the objective of this particular Yojana is to empower local youth by way of providing entry level training in the industrial specific area with respect to the railways. ठीक है, basically जो उनको entry level training होगी ताकि वो railway के किसी नौकरी में entry ले पाए, उसके regarding training provide कराई जाएगी. Alright, they will be provide entry level training industry relevant skill through railway training institutes, and total 75 railway training institutes will be engaged to provide training to the youths. Alright, and do remember that this program is under the aegis of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. ठीक है, इसके नाम से भी पता चल रहा है, Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana and Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. So do remember this, that this program, this Yojana is under the aegis of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. The nodal agency for implementing this program is Banaras Locomotive Works, and the duration of training is 100 hours. This is also important, do remember this, and there is a target of providing training to 50,000 youths in the upcoming 3 years. ठीक है, with the help of 75 railway training institute. So the target is to provide training to how many youths? 50,000 youths in the upcoming period of 3 years. All right. So this was about this news, guys, and now let's come back to the question. It was launched in September 2021. This is absolutely correct. It is under the aegis of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. This is also correct. Nodal agency for implementation is Banaras Locomotive Works. This is also correct. And the total duration of training is 100 hours. Ye bhi sahi hai. Total 1 lakh youths will be trained over a period of 3 years. No, total the target of number of youth is how much? 50,000. Total target kitna hai? 50,000 youth ko train kiya jayega in the coming period of 3 years. So the correct answer, guys, will be option E. Moving ahead to question number 2. In which of the following, and of course Minister of Railway, who is the Minister of Railway? Ashwini Vaishnav, who is also the Minister of Communication. In which of the following municipal corporations, Union Minister of Information and Broadcasting has launched My Parking App. Now who is the Minister? Anurag Singh Thakur, his Lok Sabha constituency is Hamirpur in Himachal Pradesh. So in which of the following municipal corporation he launched My Parking App? So remember guys, it was launched in South Delhi Municipal Corporation. And this app, what is the use of this app? This app, remember, will help in the hassle-free parkings, and a person can also book online parking slots before going to a certain place. मेरे को कहीं जाना है तो मैं उससे पहले ही पार्किंग की स्लॉट वहां पे बुक कर लूंगा, एंड देन आई कैन हैव हैसल फ्री पार्किंग, जो कि दिल्ली जैसे शहरों में बहुत बड़ा इशू है पार्किंग का. ओके, नाउ रिमेंबर द ऐप हैज बीन डेवलप्ड बाय ब्रॉडकास्टिंग इंजीनियरिंग कंसल्टेंट्स इंडिया लिमिटेड एंड साउथ दिल्ली म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन, एंड इट विल ऑल्सो रिड्यूस पॉल्यूशन बाय रिड्यूसिंग द टाइम इन फाइंडिंग द पार्किंग. अप्रोप्रिएट पार्किंग ढूंढने के लिए जो हम टाइम यूज करते हैं, तो ऑफकोर्स जिसमें कार चलती रहती है, सो it adds to the pollution. All right, so the correct answer will be what? South Delhi Municipal Corporation, option C. All right, moving ahead to question number 3. This is something new. Which of the following oil companies has launched UFIL technology to provide hassle-free experience of fueling. Now, this is, guys, this is something new that this company has launched. This is Bharat Petroleum Company Limited, BPCL. BPCL has launched this new, you can say, technology, this new initiative, which is known as UFIL. Now, this will help in the hassle-free fueling. With the help of this technology, with the help of this initiative, you would not have to you would not have to keep a check on the readings. जो आप पेट्रोल भराते वक्त जीरो रीडिंग और फाइनल रीडिंग को चेक करते हो वो नहीं करना पड़ेगा. एंड ऑफ कोर्स द फ्यूलिंग द रीफिलिंग विल बी डेफिनेटली पेपरलेस मतलब बिना सारा का सारा डिजिटल होगा बेसिकली. ठीक है, लेट मी रिपीट दिस. दिस इनिशिएटिव विल हेल्प यू इन हैसल फ्री फ्यूलिंग. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस इनिशिएटिव यू वुड नॉट हैव टू चेक द रीडिंग्स ऑफ द डिस्पेंसिंग मशीन जहां से पेट्रोल निकलता है. एंड नंबर टू, द पेमेंट्स विल बी डन इन एब्सोल्युटली डिजिटल मैनर. ठीक है, नाउ अब इसमें होता क्या है, लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो बेसिकली फॉर यूजिंग दिस टेक्नोलॉजी, फॉर यूजिंग दिस इनिशिएटिव, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अ कस्टमर डज नॉट हैव टू डाउनलोड अ सेपरेट ऐप. इसके लिए कोई सेपरेट ऐप नहीं होगा. दिस टेक्नोलॉजी, दिस इनिशिएटिव कैन बी यूज फ्रॉम द एग्जिस्टिंग डाउनलोडेड ऐप्स लाइक गूगल पे, फोन पे, पेटीएम जैसी ऐप से ये वाला जो इनिशिएटिव है वो यूज किया जा सकता है. ठीक है, नाउ कैसे. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द कस्टमर विल हैव टू पे इन एडवांस. द कस्टमर गोइंग टू अ बीपीसीएल पेट्रोल पंप वेयर दिस यूफिल इज फंक्शनल, वहां पे वो जाएगा, उसने पेमेंट पहले कर देगा, पेमेंट वो पहले कर चुका होगा. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन दैट द आफ्टर द पेमेंट इज डन द डिस्पेंसिंग मशीन will automatically get preset for the value of fuel paid by the customer. ठीक है, जो dispensing machine होगा that will reset itself to zero and उसके अंदर उतना ही fuel भर दिया जाएगा जितना कि उसने pay किया है. ठीक है, but let's say in certain case कि आपने 1000 rupees pay कर दिए and आपके vehicle में and your vehicle has the space for the petrol of only 900, then what will happen to this difference of rupees 100? So it will be credited back to your bank account. ठीक है, वो आपके बैंक अकाउंट में वापस चला जाएगा. सो इसके लिए भी कोई चिंता करने की जरूरत नहीं है. दिस विल एलिमिनेट द नीड टू चेकिंग जीरो और फाइनल रीडिंग एंड इफ द अमाउंट पेड इन एडवांस इज पार्शियली यूज्ड द बैलेंस अमाउंट विल बी इमीडिएटली रिफंडेड टू द बैंक अकाउंट ऑफ द कस्टमर्स. ठीक है, इन अप्रोक्सीमेटली 48 आवर्स ये जो पैसा है दैट विल बी क्रेडिटेड बैक टू योर बैंक अकाउंट फ्रॉम वेयर यू हैव मेड द दैट एडवांस पेमेंट. ओके, सो लेट मी रिपीट दिस. व्हाट विल हैपन इज दैट first of all you need not download a separate app for using this technology. You can use either Google Pay or Phone Pay or Paytm, any app that you are using. Now what you have to do before going to the BPCL petrol pump or after reaching to the BPCL petrol pump, you pay in advance, then that dispensing machine from which the petrol comes out, it will reset itself to zero and whatever the amount you have paid for the petrol, the petrol will, petrol or diesel will जो भी आपका व्हीकल होगा वो उसके अंदर चला जाएगा, पेट्रोल उसके अंदर रिफिल हो जाएगा. एंड इफ देयर इज एनी एक्स्ट्रा पेमेंट दैट यू हैव मेड, सो दैट एक्स्ट्रा पेमेंट विल क्रेडिटेड बैक टू योर अकाउंट. सो दिस हैज बीन, दिस इज समथिंग न्यू. सो आई थिंक दिस इज वेरी गुड इनिशिएटिव ऑफ बीपीसीएल. सो यस, द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी व्हाट, ऑप्शन बी, बीपीसीएल, बिकॉज इट इज बीपीसीएल विच हैज लॉन्च्ड दिस यूफिल टेक्नोलॉजी. Now moving ahead to question number 4. This is again a very good, very important question. See, a question from Ishram portal can be asked because this is something new initiative by the government of India. And ये जब हमारा COVID का scenario हुआ था उस time Supreme Court ने जो central government से the Supreme Court asked central government that what is the status of the unorganized workers in the country? Do you have any data regarding the organized workers? So you have to compile some data regarding the unorganized worker and thereafter the Ministry of Labour and Employment launched this Ishram portal where the government is collecting the data, is collecting the data from the unorganized workers. Okay? And there is a target to collect the data of 38 crores unorganized workers on this Ishram portal. Now we are discussing it because it is in news, because recently Ministry of Labour and Employment provided some data regarding the registration of unorganized worker on this portal. So they said that till now 4.09 crore workers have been registered at this portal, and out of this much amount of workers 4.09 crores. 50.02 beneficiaries are women, while rest are 49.98% are male. So approximately 50% are female and 50% are male, and this is very surprising that women and men are almost equally participating in registering on this portal. Top four states with highest number of registrations are Odisha, West Bengal, UP and Bihar. Odisha, West Bengal, UP and Bihar. ये नंबर वन पे उड़ीसा है, नंबर टू पे वेस्ट बंगाल, देन नंबर थ्री पे यूपी एंड नंबर फोर बिहार. एंड हाईएस्ट नंबर ऑफ रजिस्टर्ड वर्कर्स आर फ्रॉम एग्रीकल्चर एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन सेक्टर. नाउ गाइस, इफ योर एग्जाम इज कमिंग अप इन वन और टू मंथ्स, देन यू शुड रिमेंबर दीज थ्री डेटा, अदरवाइज यू शुड नॉट, बिकॉज दिस कीप्स ऑन चेंजिंग. एक महीने के बाद नंबर ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन बढ़ जाएंगी डेफिनेटली, ठीक है, ये परसेंटेज भी चेंज हो जाएगा, टॉप फोर भी चेंज हो सकता है. सो इफ योर एग्जाम इज विद इन वन टू मंथ्स, then you should remember this data, otherwise this data is of no use for the exam. All right, now what is important for exam is the information regarding Ishram portal. So as I told you, this portal was launched by Ministry of Labour and Employment, and our objective of this portal is to provide welfare benefits under the government schemes to all the unorganized workers by registering them into this portal. And then ab register karne se fayda kya hoga, what will be the benefit of registration? So the benefit will be that the government will have a record of that particular organized unorganized worker, and then any kind of welfare can be provided to that worker. All right, workers after registering on the portal gets an e-shram card containing a 12 digit unique number, theek hai, and he jo unorganized worker hai usko bar bar har jagah register karne ki zarurat nahi hai. There is no need of registration at different places for having the benefits of different welfare schemes. ठीक है, अलग अलग जगहों पे जाके अलग अलग registration करने की जरूरत नहीं है. This is very good thing about this Ishram portal. Now also remember, the Ishram card is applicable across the country. So as I told you, there is no need to register for having benefits at different places. Also remember, very important thing, if a worker is registered at the Ishram portal and he meets with an accident, and if he died or if there is any permanent disability, 2 lakh rupees will be given. If he or she dies, 2 lakh rupees will be given to the nominee, and if there is permanent disability, 2 lakh rupees will be given to him or her, and if there is partial disability, rupees 1 lakh will be given. Okay, so this, guys, is also basically the government is providing insurance to the unorganized worker absolutely free of cost. Isme koi paisa nahi le rahi government. So now let's come back to the question. Question was regarding this insurance amount only is provided to a worker registered on Ishram portal. So yes, that's rupees 2 lakh. If he or she died, agar mar jate hain to 2 lakh rupees milenge. Permanent disability pe bhi 2 lakh aur temporary disability pe 1 lakh. Alright, temporary keh lo ya partial keh lo. Question number 5, which is the last question for today. Which of the following ministries has organized Food Tech Summit 2021 on the occasion of World Food Day? Now, can you tell me when is the World Food Day observed? World Food Day kab manaya jata hai? Please write down in the comments. And kal jo maine ministry ka question pucha tha yaar, bahut kam comments aaye hain. Kam se kam question ka answer to de diya karo. Main besharam ho gaya hu ye baat kehte kehte ki jo question main puchta hu uska answer de diya karo. But I don't know ki kyon nahi aata response. And I don't believe ki minister of communication ka naam keval 7-8 logo ko pata hai out of 1000 पीपल जिन्होंने ये वीडियो देखी, जिन्होंने कल वाली वीडियो देखी थी. तो प्लीज कमेंट कर दिया करो, जो भी आपको आता है या नहीं आता है कुछ तो कमेंट करो, ठीक है, नहीं आता है तो भी कर दो. वर्ल्ड फूड डे कब होता है ये आपको बताना है. सो दिस मिनिस्ट्री गाइस इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री, एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो रिमेंबर दैट दिस फूड टेक समिट 2021 was organized under the scheme Pradhan Mantri PM Formalization of Micro Food Processing Enterprises Scheme. PM Formalization of Micro Food Processing Enterprises Scheme ke under this Food Tech Summit 2021 was organized by Ministry of Food Processing Industry on the World Food Day. So option A will be the correct answer. And that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you on Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.